I guess at this point we'll have Frank sign his letter of intent.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for coming. I have some people I haven't seen in a while, and I'd like to thank them for coming. Number one person I'd like to thank is both my parents. Ever since I started high school, they've always supported me, helped me through all the tough times, been there for me, and been my biggest supporters. Without them, I wouldn't be where I am today.
That there is another DiMaggio that might play Major League Baseball someday?
You know, it seems like maybe nowadays a lot of the players play for the money or for the publicity, but, you know, when Joe DiMaggio played, he played really because he loved it, and that's the approach I try to take when I go out on the field. Who look up to you as a person and just try to set a good example for them and try to bring baseball, you know, back to...
Fascinate Americans. Baseball.
Joe DiMaggio is my third cousin.
And bad dates. Now on Change of Heart, you get a little bit of both.
What is it about the third cousin of the Yankee Clipper?
All you do is talk about yourself.
He and his date went from VIP to VI police.
It was terrible. I couldn't get out of the night fast enough. She shook my hand. I washed it three times.
Harsh. But what chased her off the playing field?
What was that all about?
Now on Change of Heart.
Frank DiMaggio, surgical consultant from New Jersey. Strategy, think and move cautiously. Chained together, on the run as fugitives.
We gotta make time.
They're gonna see us.
So looking back, just look forward.
On their trail, a team of professional trackers.
Now where are they going? Where could they go?
We got our tracks out front.
Oh, we got a bogey.
Come on, we're burning daylight.
Clock's ticking.
In the next 24 hours, they'll have to make it across 21 miles of open desert.
Let's make it simple.
Let's get out of here.
I got tracks right here.
Can they escape some of the world's best trackers and survive one of the toughest environments on Earth? Find out on The Chase, Track Down.
Up for him.
DiMaggio at the plate.
But you know what? We're going to see a lot more of Chris Heck.
Mm-hmm.
I think he would have been drafted a lot higher than the 26th round, but the word really had gone around that he really wanted to play college baseball.
DiMaggio gets into this one. Watson would have a heck of a time to get here. He cannot do it as it's into the bullpen. And Frank DiMaggio, and what will very probably be his last time at the plate in the Carpenter Cup, will have a thrill. Something to remember, a home run into the bullpen and left field.
Oh, he really tagged that. We mentioned he had 10 in the regular season and showed his power. And Mike, out of all the games this season, that's the first home run I've seen out of the park. I haven't seen them all.
Tonight on MSC, Fox Sports News. Three balls and one strike on Frank DiMaggio.
Gone.
Sends a high fly ball to deep left field. No chance for Quinlan here. A three-run home run for DiMaggio.
I can't remember when you were there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything there is, can't imagine anything.
Flags at the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, New York are flying at half-staff today. Baseball great Joe DiMaggio died today at his home in Florida. He had undergone lung cancer surgery in October and had battled to regain his health ever since. University of Delaware baseball player Frank DiMaggio is the ballplayer's third cousin. We talked to him today about his recollections of his famous and beloved relative.
You were growing up and admire Joe DiMaggio or want to be like him, should not only want to be like him because of the great player he was, but also want to be like him because of the great person he was.
And I'm so glad I stayed right here with you through the years. I can't.
Fayetteville, Arkansas is the next stop for the Blue Hens and a date with the Southeastern Conference power.
Turf, which is going to be a big plus for them. Hopefully what we're hoping is that they'll underestimate us a little bit, come and think,
Perseverance is a word that would best describe the 1999 edition of Delaware baseball. It is also a word that characterizes the senior season of Blue Hens third baseman Frank DiMaggio, who saw his cousin and New York Yankee Hall of Famer Joe pass away in March.
When Joe passed away, it was just something that not only affected our family, but all the baseball world. And I definitely wanted to dedicate the season to Joe. And even more recently, right before the championship series, my grandmother died the day before the championship series. So I wanted to dedicate our last day to my grandmother to see, if we could really step it up for her. And actually, we did. I had a good series, and we ended up winning. So, I mean, there's been a lot of things that have happened throughout this year that have been real emotional. But couldn't end it any better. I mean, we came all the way back to win it. I mean, it's just a great way to go. Down, you've turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. I've loved the life we.
The story of a local high school kid with a Hall of Fame pedigree.
He has the name and the game. Frank DiMaggio Jr. is an Archbishop.
Everybody's always watching you. If your name is Jones or Smith or something, then you might have a really good game, but they might forget about it. But if your name's DiMaggio and you have a good game, it seems like.
To have hope, you know you got to be strong.